have you been overspending with your service? You really need to take a look at this video to show you how to save big time.
Hey guys, so this is an overview video on FunnelJoy. I will try to keep it short and sweet, straight to the point. Okay, so when you are registered for the first time or you log into your FunnelJoy account, you will be greeted with your default account. So everyone is given a default account on sign up. So this is my default account, which I have renamed to XYZ. On your dashboard, you have an overview of your analytics. So number of campaigns, number of pages, visitors, contacts, and number of orders. Below here, you see a list of my campaigns. I have two campaigns created already. If we look at the navigation, you have campaigns, which is this page I'm on. You have sell, which is your products and your orders, contacts, or you can say leads. You have your account settings, and then you have your account profile and billing. If at any time you need help, feel free to click our help icon over there to the right. And you'll be taken straight to our support desk / knowledge base. So we would have a number of videos to help you through and FAQs as well. At the top as well, you have notifications. That's if there's any in-app notification, it will show up here. And then you have your sub-accounts. So you can see that if I click this, you can see the two sub-accounts that I have created. I have X and I have XYZ sub-account. And I can also create a new sub-account if I want to. You can check the sub-account video to know how to learn how to do that. Okay, so first thing in FunnelJoy is campaigns. So to create a campaign, you simply click create campaign. Let's give this campaign one. Click create. So your campaign is also your funnel. So campaign, funnel, just a different word to call it. Now in your campaigns, you then have this sub navigation, your list of pages, analytics for this campaign or funnel, your domains associated with this campaign, settings for this campaign, global scripts for this campaign. So I'll quickly run through what each of them are. So let's go to global scripts. Global scripts is where you add scripts that you want to be displayed on all of the pages in this particular campaign. So for example, your Google Analytics code, you don't want to have to remember to place it in each and every page that you create. So if you paste it in here, if you're told to paste it as a head script, or if you're told to paste it as a body script, so you paste it in here and save. So on every page you create in this campaign, you would have this code automatically added to each one. If we go over to settings, here you can adjust the campaign name. You can take your campaign offline if you want to. You can also delete. Deleting it means it's gone forever. So GDPR, we have to delete every single thing. Domains. So here you can customize your domain for your FunnelJoy campaign. So normally we give you a URL to your campaign when you sign up and when you create a new campaign, but it's what I'll call an ugly URL. So you wouldn't want to be giving that to your customers. So you can create a subdomain here. So I can call this campaign1.funneljoy.com. Or if I have campaign1.com registered, I can pick this option, type it in here, and point my DNS record to it and save. If we go to analytics, what you would have here is a list of all your pages that you've created. So I think what I'll do at this point is go back to a campaign that has already been created. Okay, so this is the campaign that I've created. This is the URL, so you can see it's a bit ugly. If I go to analytics, so you can see page views, all uniques, my opt-ins, and my sales analytics as well. Let's go back to pages. So here, when you create a new page, your pages are listed here for you to see. So this is page name. This means I can reorder this. Now, the reordering helps you to determine what the homepage of your campaign would be. We'll go into more detail about funnels in subsequent videos. So all you have to do is just click new page. If I call this page one, we have two editors in FunnelJoy, drag and drop and advanced. The difference is both of them are, would I say, click to drop in canvas or drag to the canvas, but the drag and drop allows you to freely move those elements to anywhere you want, while the advanced is more structured web design. So you have to place things in columns and arrange things properly. So if I go with the drag and drop editor, I click save. I then get a list of templates. So we have landing page / opt-in, we have sales order pages, we have webinar, we have 404 pages. So if I select, let's go with this 404 page, and you can also use a blank template, but you have to pick your blank template under the type that you want. So if you say sales and order, and then you click use blank template, that would create a sales and orders page, but blank. So if we use this 404 page, you can see that it's loaded up the editor, and you can do a number of things in this editor. We would have a video that goes in depth into this editor. So I'll just return back to my campaign. Yeah, so back to the campaign. So this is the new page that has been created. So if I want this 404 page to be the first one, I just move that right up, and this becomes the first page in this campaign. Now, we'll jump over to sell. So in sell, this is where you create your products. So you can see here, I have three products. I have a course product as well. So all you need to do to create a product, just click new product, type in the details. Is this a membership product? Payment option, pricing, fulfillment email, and then save that. You will also have your orders to see a list of people who have bought from you. If we go to contacts, you have a list of your leads or contacts, people who have signed up on any of your pages. You can filter this by campaign as well, so that you're able to easily pick which set of contacts you want to see. If we go to settings, so in settings, you have your integrations. We have a bunch of integrations, and we would be adding more in there over time. You can also go to teams. So here you can see team member and the admin on this one. You can invite new people to your account. You see your pending invitations, and then you can resend if you need to, or you delete if you don't want to. When you add someone to the team and they accept the invitation, they will be listed here, and you have to add them to a sub-account. So you select a sub-account and add them to it, else they wouldn't be given access to your sub-accounts. Now, in sub-account settings, you can change the sub-account name, change the sub-account currency. We allow you to use a number of different currencies. And then you can also delete the sub-account if you wish to. If we go to account, here you can modify your profile settings. So edit your profile, change your password, delete your account, and then your billing details as well. So this is an overview of FunnelJoy. I hope I wasn't too fast with it. Check our other videos to see how to use each of these features in the best way. Cheers, guys.
You've got everything you need to either win or whine. You decide. Just do it soon.